It's one of the most anticipated high-end smartphones of the year, and the LG G2 is finally in the PhoneDog offices. I'm Aaron Baker from PhoneDog.com. This is LG's answer to the Galaxy S4, the HTC One, and all those other high-end devices that are coming out this holiday season. How does it compare, and can LG compete with their availability of the G2 on the four carriers? Let's find out in the unboxing. The LG G2 is LG's number one competitor to the Galaxy S4, to the newly announced Sony Xperia Z1, which was actually just announced a few minutes ago, and other high-end devices on the market like the HTC One. LG is back in a big way. This is coming to the four nationwide carriers in the US, so they've secured that deal across all the carriers, making this a top contender as we go into the holiday season for a high-end smartphone. The G2 specs-wise is packing some awesome killer specs as well. It's got a Snapdragon 800 CPU. It's got a 2.1 megapixel front-facing camera, 13 megapixel rear-facing camera with optical image stabilization, and I should point out this is the global version, so obviously when the US versions come, we'll test those as well with 4G LTE connectivity. Special thanks to LG for getting this over to us, and also special thanks to our partners at Best Buy Mobile for giving us devices like the G2 for use in our One Pawed Bandit giveaway game, which is our free game on PhoneDog.com. When you go into Best Buy Mobile, when this G2 does come out on the carriers, they'll make sure you pick the carrier that's right for you. They're not paid on commission. Whether it's Verizon or AT&T or Sprint or T-Mobile, they'll hook you up with what works right for you at Best Buy Mobile. So let's take a look. Here's the device itself right here out of the box. And again, going back through the specifications, 2.26 gigahertz Snapdragon 800 CPU with Adreno 330 GPU. You've got a 5.2 inch display here with 424 pixels per inch, 1080p HD display. So a beautiful big display, and it takes up most of the front of the device, making the bezels on the side very small in comparison. So on the back, what we talked about in the press conference, power button and volume rocker are on the back. You don't get anything on the sides here because LG's research says it's really hard, or it was really hard for people, to press the buttons on the side. It was easy to drop the phone. So they put the buttons where your index finger naturally goes, which is on the back of the device. You can see some stickers here, IMEI information down here at the bottom, which I presume will be very similar on the US versions. I'm assuming the sticker will come there as well. And I've got stickers on my hands, so let me try and get these off. So you can see power button back here on the back, and of course volume rocker, and then you can use the knock feature, which we'll show you in the video here in just a second, to turn the display on and off. So we'll pull this off as well. Like I said, 13 megapixel camera with optical image stabilization, 2 gigabytes of RAM. There should be a 16 and a 32 gigabyte variant, though that will depend on the region, and I'll put that right there so it can start up and you can see the animation sequence while we see what comes at least in the international box. LG G2 quick start guide. You've got a European AC adapter module here with the USB adapter area on the front, which that's pretty cool. And then quick startup as well. You got some earbuds here, Quad Beat 2 earphones. I'll put those to the test. And Life is Good, the Vienna Boys Choir, and USB cable as well. So obviously they did the partnership with the Vienna Boys Choir, as you saw at the press conference on August 7th. And there are a lot of ringtones pre-installed out of the box that are Vienna Boys ringtones, or Vienna Boys Choir ringtones. So double tap to turn on the device. You do not have to press the button on the back. You can see my finger is off. Tap, tap. And you can activate the display. Much easier in some cases than pressing the power button, and this offers a wealth of features as well, including holding it up to your ear when you get a phone call to take the phone call. But really, the thing about this device, couple of things. It's one of the first Snapdragon 800 CPU-based devices to be announced, along with the Sony Xperia Z Ultra. And then, of course, we assume the Galaxy Note 3, which should be announced later today. But anyway, the G2, really nice all around. On-screen buttons here, and what I like about this, I saw this and showed this off to you at the press conference when I was there in New York City. We'll go into the display here so you can take a look. Front touch buttons, I can change these around. So perhaps I'm coming from a device where the menu button's on the left side. Well, I can do the back button on the left side as well. I can add this also, pull the notification panel down. That's a pretty cool feature, so I don't have to reach all the way up on the display. I've got a shortcut button. You can make this your own. You've got different themes as well. So customization runs fresh on this device. You've got black or white buttons you can choose down here. And so let's say, you know what, I want to change the theme to white. I can make it look white just like that. And then alongside that, I've got my home screen, my lock screen customizations, and a lot of these are things you've seen from previous LG devices, but LG's user interface much better than what we've seen in previous versions. I think back to like 2010, 2011 at Mobile World Congress. I think of that user interface, and I think of where we're at now with this device and the Optimus G Pro, a world of difference all around. So I can change the screen swipe effect. I've got a bunch of different options here. Portrait view only, my themes within the device itself, basic or marshmallow. And then I can go back to home here and take a look. But overall, as you would expect with a Snapdragon 800 CPU, this thing is incredibly fast combined with 2 gigabytes of RAM. Really a nice device all around. And you have some new goodies as well. We'll go into messaging here so you can see settings. And we'll go into, for example, text message area. We'll go down. Actually, you know what? We'll go back to conversation theme is what I was looking for. So a couple of different options here to select the back wallpaper. I can make it the ocean. I can change the bubbles around. So this is something I've always enjoyed on the later versions of TouchWiz, like the Galaxy Note 2, the Galaxy S4. You can change it around and really make it your own. So you may like the Moto X customization, but maybe you don't want a Moto X. This still gives you some level of software customization and allows you to get a device that you want if you don't care for the Moto X. So obviously lots of different choices out there depending on what you like, but this just adds to the flavor in my opinion when it comes to customization. So I can click there and we'll take a look. Yep, we'll change those themes. And then I'll go into messaging to show you the keyboard here. So again, 5.2 inch display, and LG was pretty big on saying this 5.2 inch display, the reason why they went with this size was because according to their research, it's the biggest display you can get and still feel comfortable in one hand. So travel here, pretty hard for me even with big fingers to get all the way across from one side to the other, but still 5.2 inches according to them is the go-to screen size for something where you can get, you know, maximum viewability for content consumption, but then still have a screen that's small enough to fit in your pocket and small enough to travel across with ease. So I'll just say the Quick Brown Fox is ready for the weekend. Quick Brown Fox is ready for the weekend. LG's keyboard here, you can see it auto-corrects words and it continues to change both in look and in overall functionality as well. I find that, you know, looking back to LG again from 2011 to now, the keyboard has gotten substantially better, and I'll bring it up close to the camera so you can take a look at what it looks like. Keyboard looks good here. You've got a dedicated number pad up top as well. And last but not least, we'll take a look at the browser and we'll load up phonedog.com just so you can see what it looks like on the, not PhoneDig, I do that all the time, phonedog.com. We'll load that up so you can see it on the 5.2 inch display. 1080p looks good on this device. I'll have more on that in the full review and then subsequent dogfights. But again, portrait to landscape transitions, nice and fast here. Really pleased with that, except for that time. A little slow there, but usually pretty quick. And then last but not least, I know I said that before, I want to cover a couple of other things in the user interface, including the application. So you can see apps and widgets here. You've got cell broadcast, and because this is an unlocked device, you're not getting any carrier installed stuff. It's more Google integration stuff. And then, of course, some of the LG goodies as well. Quick Translator, Safety Care, Polaris Viewer 5, File Manager, Dictionary, and more. And, of course, I have my widgets over here. Analog clocks, bookmarks, digital clocks, Gmail, all the stuff you would expect on the LG G2. Now, there are a wealth of software goodies on this device. This is kind of like LG's version of the later versions of TouchWiz on Samsung. So there are a lot of hidden goodies in the software that I look forward to covering in subsequent videos. So keep it locked in PhoneDog for continuing coverage of the LG G2. Let me know what you want to see. I'm on Twitter at PhoneDog_Aaron, Facebook, Facebook.com/HiAaronBaker. More to come from this device, the LG G2, on PhoneDog.com, including Android 4.2 goodies and things that are under the hood software-wise and hardware-wise. Keep it locked here. Stay tuned for more on the G2, and I'll see you next time.